this class we are going to start a new lesson, that is lesson number 3, the animal world. Lesson number 3, the animal world. Now everyone take out your same one textbook. In that page number 153, page number 153, lesson number 3, the animal world. Okay. We see many animals around our home and locality. Some of them are seen in inside our home too. Animals like frog, snake can be found in the gardens. So what is mean by animals, children? So animals, like maybe it is a big, very big or huge, maybe a small animal. Okay. Also the animals will be having a sense organs. Animals will be having a sense organs. This and various type of animals will be there. For example, here to your home you can able to see dog, cat. Okay. So those animals will come under a domestic animal. And few animals we can able to find out only in a forest area. That is called as a wild animal. Okay. The animals will be having a four limbs. For example, two hands, two legs. They will be walking in a four legs, right? So it is called as a four limbs. Okay. Also, it will be having a tail. And few animals will be having a horn. So like that, we can able to see different type of animals. Okay. So today in this class, we are going to study only about animals. So how the animals eat the food, and what is the animal house's name, and what are all the useful things we will get from the animals. Okay, so in your home, even you will be having some pet animals like a dog or cat or small thing. Okay, some animals we can able to see outside of home. Okay, for example, you can take a street dog. Okay, it will be roaming in the street, in and around your homes it will be roaming. Okay, those animals it is called as a domestic animal. And few animals like lion, tiger, deer you can able to see only in a forest area. Those animals it is called as a wild animal. Like that animal it will be having a different shape, color, size. Okay, all the animals won't look like the same. Even few animals will be having a teeth, and few animals it will fully covered with their body with hairs, and few animals it will be having a normal skin. Okay, like this we can able to find out different types of animals. Okay, so here in the textbook they have given you, what animals do you see at the following place? Okay, so here they are given garden, zoo, farmhouse and water. Now we have to write those animals. Which are the animals we can able to see in a garden? What is the animal we can able to see? In garden we can see frog. F-R-O-G, frog and snake. These two animals usually we can able to see in the garden. And next one, in zoo, what and all animal we can able to see in zoo? Most of the animal they kept inside the, yes, in garden also we can able to see colorful butterflies, right? It will be coming and sitting on the flowers. Okay, so I am giving here three options. Any two you can select and write. Which are the animals you like? Okay, so that animals you can see, that animals name you can write in your textbook. Okay, in garden we can able to see frog, butterfly, snake and insect. Okay, like the different types of animals it will be there in the garden. And next, in zoo, what are the major animals we can able to see? Lion and tiger. So in zoo we can see the lion and tiger, we used to keep in a separate shelter, right? So it is a very dangerous animal. Okay, so in zoo we can able to see lion and tiger. Next, in farmhouse, what kind of animal we can see? In farmhouse we can able to see cow, goat and hen. So like this, different kinds of animal it will be there in the farmhouse. Okay, and next, water animal. What is meant by water animals? Which are the animals it will be living in the water? It is called as a water animal, or it is called as a aquatic animals. Now we are going to see which are the animals it will be surviving in the water. what are we able to find out many types of animal. For example, I gave fish, octopus, dolphin. Okay, I'm going to repeat once again. I have all everything I wrote three children, and you have to write in your textbook only two. You have to write. Okay, in garden we can able to see frog, snake, and butterfly. And zoo we can see lion, tiger, wolf, etc. In farmhouse we can see cow, goat, and hen. In water animals we can able to see fish, octopus, and dolphin. See children, you have to write like this. They are given two lines, right? You have to write only two animals name. Okay, so you have to write it in the pencil, write neatly, don't make any mistakes. And next one we are going to see, based on the animal character they are going to divide into a three groups. Okay, based on the animal character there are three groups. The first one is a pet animal, second one is a domestic animal, and third one is a wild animal. Okay, there are three groups of animals, that is pet animal, domestic animal, wild animal. So what is mean by pet animal? In a home we'll grow some animals, right, like a dog or cat. Okay, so those it will come under category of pet animals. Which are the animals we are growing inside our house, it is called as a pet animals. Example, dog and cat. The pet animals we have to take a proper care, right? The proper care means what? So every day we have to make them to bath, and every correct time we have to feed them. Also regular visit we have to take to the doctor if it is any infections, or if got any wound, or it has got any hurt, immediately we have to take to the doctor for the treatment. Also we have to give separate space for that, for living purpose. Okay, in a home we have to give little separate space for their living. Okay, also which are the place it is roaming, we have to keep it clean. Okay, in pet animals we have to give proper care for them. We have to feed them on a regular basis, morning, afternoon, night time. Also we have to take for a walking, for evening time, morning time, we have to take for a walking. Also we can play with them. Okay, it will be like exercise for them. And also if it got any infections, or if it got any wound or hurt, okay, we have to take to the doctor on a regular basis. Also every day we have to make them to take bath. And which are the place it is living, no? We have to keep it as a clean. For them only we have to give little space for the living purpose. So here we can see in the textbook, animals can be divided in three groups. One, pet. Two, domestic. And third, wild. So now we are going to read pet animal. Pet animals. Animals that are kept at home are called pet animal. Example, cat, dog, rabbits, etc. are some pet animals. We must take proper care for our pets. So what are the care we have to take, that they have given in a point wise. The first one, feed the pet at regular intervals. Take the pet for a walk, play with it. And next point, take the pet to the doctor when it falls sick. Give a bath to the pet. Make a living space for the pet. Keep it clean. Next, we have moved on for a domestic animal. What does mean by domestic animal? In our house, okay, in our house surrounded by some animals will be there, no? For example, cow, goat, or even stray dogs also will be there. So those animals it will come under category of domestic animal. Okay. Example, cow, goat, buffaloes. Okay, so these are the animals we can able to grow in home. Okay, so we can able to see around the house, right? So those animals it is called as a domestic animals. Also these animals are useful to us. How it will useful to us? For example, cow it will give us a milk, and hen it will lay the eggs. Like that, more example we are going to see in the textbook. So here you can see domestic animal. Animals seen living and in or around our house is called domestic animal.
These animals are useful to us. Cows, buffaloes, goat, etc. These are the example of domestic animals. Also, it will be useful to us. So, those animals are called as domestic animals. These animals are useful in our daily life. Example, cow gives us milk and hen gives eggs and donkey carries a load.
This example we have seen, no? The milk, the buffalo, goat or cow, it will give a milk to us. Okay. Also, the hen, it will lay the egg. The egg it will be having in a daily life. Also, the dog, the stray dogs are not seeing the thief, it will be start barking. Okay. So, it will be giving a signal to us. Okay. Also, in our house, the more rat, and the rat is more means we can leave the cat for 1 or 2 days. All the rat will be run away. So, like this, various types of helpfulness it will be there for the domestic animals. Okay. And next one, we are going to see a wild animal. What is mean by wild animal? Animal live in a forest. Okay. That animal we can't able to pamper in home and all. Okay. So, this animal, it will be living in a forest. So, this animal it is called as a wild animal. Example, lion, tiger, wolf, elephant, etc. Okay, there are so many types of wild animals are there that we can't able to grow in a home. So, it will be living in a forest. Okay. So, those animals it is called as a wild animals. Example, lion, tiger, wolf. These animals are very dangerous because it will be having a flush of other animals. Okay, it is not safe to grow in a home. So, it will be growing in the forest. So, this is a very dangerous animal.
And here you can see wild animal. Animals which live in a forest are called wild animal. They are very dangerous. So, people cannot keep them around. They cannot be tamed. Lion, wolf, tiger, bear, etc. are some wild animals. Here also you can able to see rhinoceros and tiger and kangaroo. So, these animals it will be living in always in a forest. So, that is the reason it is called as a wild animals. It is very dangerous because it will be eating a flesh of other animals. So, it is not safe to keep it in home. And
next topic we are going to see on a food that animals eat. Okay. What kind of food animals will eat, children? For example, some animals will be having a plant source like a leaf or a grass. And some animals will be having a flesh of other animals. Like different animals will be having a different type of food appetites. Okay. All the animals it won't have a same food. For example, cow, buffalo and goats it will be having a plant sources. Okay. For example, leaf or grass it will have. But tiger, lion and some other animals if we take for example, aigner, vulture or so it will be having a flesh of other animals. Okay. Different animals it will be having a different types of food habits. Food habits. Okay. Why it need food? Because how the humans will have the food, then only we will be getting energy, right? Likewise, for the animals also, if it is eating the food, then only it will get the energy. Also, this food is helpful to growth and development of the body. Also, it will stay alive. If it is not having the food, means it can't able to survive, right? So, compulsory it need to have the food. So, it will be helpful for growth and development of the body. And next one, as I mentioned, some animals it will eat only the plant source and some animals it will eat flesh of other animals. Okay. So, here you can see food that animals eat. Animals are living beings. They need food to grow and stay alive. Different animals eat different food. Some of them eat grass, leaves, etc. and some eat flesh of other animals. So, here you can see what are the food it will eat based on the animal name. Here you can able to see the food they eat. For example, dog it will eat milk, bread, rice or meat. Whatever the food the human used to have, the same food also the dog used to have. That is milk, bread, rice, meat.
And next one, cat. Cat, it will eat the rat. Also, it will drink the milk and creamy product it will eat. And next one, sparrow and hen. Okay, the birds, it's always used to have a worms on the grains, pulses, cereals like ragi, wheat, rice, like that cereals, grains and it will have, right? The sparrow and hen, like birds, it will have worms. For example, earthworms and all, it will dig in the soil and it will have the normal worms, whatever it is present in the soil. So that also it will be having. So the sparrow and the hen, it will be having worms and grains. And next one, rabbit, deer, goat, etc. So these all are, it is completely depends on plants. Okay, rabbit, deer, goat, cow, buffalo. So completely depends on plant source. So it will be having a grass. Also you can see rabbit will be having a fruits also, right? Fruits and vegetables it will be having. And next one, cow and buffalo. The cow and buffalo, it will have grass or husk. Okay, so grass or husk, also the plant leaves or other parts of the plant it will have. Next, crow. The crow, it will have grains and insect. Also it will have the meat. Okay, the crow is, it will have both plant source, also it will eat the animal source. So it will have grains and insect and meats. Next one, lion, crocodile, eagle, flesh of other animals. So it will have flesh of other animals.
So just now we are going to see a small recap whatever we have studied. Okay, all the animals, it won't be a same. Okay, also it won't have a same kind of food, it will be having a different type of food. Also we can see all the animals will be having a different shape and size and color. Okay, animals will be having a four limbs, few animals will be having a horns and tails. Even the animals also having the sense organs. Okay, so here we are going to divide into a three groups based on the character. Okay, first one is a pet animal. It used to grow in a home as a pet. For example, dog and cat. Okay, for the pet animals we have to give a proper care. Okay, so regular basis we have to feed them and we have to take for walking or evening and morning time. Also, if it has got any infection or any hurt, so we have to take it to the doctor for the treatment. On regular basis, we have to make them to bath and water the place will be rolled. You know, all the places we have to keep it as a clean. So this it will come under category of pet animal. And next one is a domestic animal. So domestic animals, we won't grow in a home, it will be around our house. Okay, for example, cow, cat, cow, goat, buffalo, sometimes it will come under category of cat also. Okay, so domestic animal, it is around our house. Okay, example, cow, goat, buffaloes. This animals, it will be very, very much useful for us. For example, cow, it will give the milk and hen, it will lay the egg. Also, I have given few examples that if it is a street dog, any strangers, if you see, it will start barking. Okay, like this, it will be useful for our humans. And next one, wild animal. So it will be always live in a forest because it is very dangerous animal. Okay, so example, lion, tiger and wolf. And food for food that animals eat. Different types of animal eat different types of food. Okay, all the animals, it won't eat the same type of food. Why it want to need food? Okay, it need food for growth and development of the body. Also, it will help us to stay alive. Okay, for example, domestic animal, cow, goat or buffalo, it will be having a plant sources, for example, grass or other part of the plant like leaves or fruit or vegetable it will be having. But some animals, it will be having a flesh of other animals. Okay. So now skill where I have done, you have to read the lesson children. If you have any doubt, you can come up in an interactive session. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.